Here's more about the infertility in men with regard to causes. We have varicoceles, which we'll talk about in a little bit, but there is trauma to the testes, the unhealthy lifestyle, the use of certain medications, hormonal disorders, genetic disorders. Doctors, let me ask you, when you have patients come through your office here and we're looking at these causes here, is there a greater average of what you're seeing now than you did in the past?
It's actually interesting. The infertility rates really haven't changed much. A lot of this list, it's about half and half on what's reversible and what's not. Obviously, a trauma or a genetic disorder is not really reversible, but hormonal disorders and certain medical conditions can be treated, which can reverse the effects on infertility. But the infertility rates in general, the initial presenting infertility rates haven't changed over time. Our ability to treat them has helped.
With regard to causes, though, have any of those causes changed in the last couple of decades? Granted that you're staying about the same on infertility, but are the causes fluctuating?
We are seeing a little more issues with hormonal disorders because of obesity, and that actually can affect your fertility. The other thing about varicoceles, the first thing on that list, is that we see more patients with varicoceles because we diagnose them more now. It used to be that we didn't know much about them and they were often overlooked, but now with more awareness, we're able to identify things more commonly.